Hi everybody, so this is my July favorites and July favorites. It's like August the 9th already. I don't know, it's a little over a week into August. But I figured I would just do this now because I really actually had some good things that I wanted to show you guys. So skipping it was definitely not an option. Okay, so let's get this part rolling here. First favorite is what I've been wearing on my toes nonstop all month, except for today. I actually made the change last night, but I have been wearing Essie's Accrued Interest, which is just this really pretty, I don't know, light, I want to call it a very, very light peach color. It's not a peachy pink, it's straight up just a light peach color. And I've been wearing this on my toes because I just think light creamy colors look so good when you are tanner or just have a little bit of color on you. I definitely wouldn't wear this on my toes during the winter because I'm like lighter than an NC15 in the winter. So, but this is amazing now because it's in, well, it's the starting of August and it's still technically summer. So that is my first favorite. This is going to be totally random, no particular order. My next one is going to be a skin care product type deal. Because in the summer I have, well, all year round I have oily skin. Even like in the coldest winters, I could probably go to Russia in the winter and just still be an oil slick on my face. So I like, especially in the summer, I still like to wear moisturizers on my face under my foundation. But I try to pick a less greasy feeling moisturizer. I like the ones that, you know, I like the Clinique gel moisturizer because it sinks into my skin so quickly and there's no oily feeling. But I ran out of that stuff, so I decided to pick up some Cebu Beauty, the Cebu line. And this has Sea Buckthorn. This is the Sea Buckthorn Daytime Facial Cream. It's the Repair and Protect, 100% natural. It's just called the Daytime Facial Cream. And I don't know that it's supposed to be used as a moisturizer or if that's what you would consider a moisturizer, but I use it as a moisturizer. It's not a gel, like I've already used a ton of it and I think I just got this like 2 weeks ago. But yeah, I absolutely love this stuff. It's really lightweight. Again, it's 100% natural. Paraben free, cruelty free, so that's cool. And I do use other Cebu skincare products, so I don't know if you guys want a separate video on the Cebu line, my review or whatever, but this is what I'm using as a moisturizer during the summer especially. I'm probably still going to continue using it into, you know, the fall and winter because I really, really like it. It does a job and it sits well under my foundation, on my skin and all of that, so really love this. Okay. Next, these are drugstore products. In love with the Revlon Just Bitten Kissable Balm Stains, especially these two. This is Precious, this is Honey. Precious is the nudie one, and then Honey is the pinkier nudie one. But yeah, that is Precious right there. You could barely see it, but that's what I like about it. And the one right above it is Honey. In love, so totally in love with both of these. Next is the Buxom lip cream in White Russian. So this was part of my last Sephora haul video, so that should tell you a little bit why I love this so much. But it really is just a nice little pinky nude color. It's right there, and I like to wear it over top any of the lip balm stains. Next. Okay, there's two products from e.l.f. eyeslipspace.com. Link in the description box below. I don't think I've ever featured an e.l.f. makeup item in one of my favorites video. I think I've featured the Miss Set Spray in maybe one, and I think that's about it. I don't know. Some e.l.f. products are hit and miss. For me anyways. I do have my HG or Holy Grail e.l.f. products. I have a video completely dedicated to e.l.f. products. I'll put a link to that in the description box below if you're interested to see all the e.l.f. products that I like. But that was kind of, recorded, I consider, a long time ago. And these two products are brand new. So the first one is from the Dollar Line, and it is the e.l.f. Cover Everything Concealer, and I have the one in medium. I also have the one in corrective yellow, but my favorite would probably be this medium color. And it is just a really nice creamy texture. It covers fairly well. I don't use it under my eyes, I just use it to cover blemishes, and it does match my skin tone on my face pretty well. So I really like this, and for a dollar, come on. It's still in the crappy, cheap-looking packaging, but I'm more worried about the product in that cheap packaging, so I actually really like it. Definitely check it out if you're looking for a nice, creamy concealer. Definitely like this to cover up some discoloration and spotting on my face. So that's the first e.l.f. product. The next one is the e.l.f. HD powder, or the high-definition powder. Comes in a little box like this, and it has a little powder puff inside. This one is new. They do have the white translucent one. This one is actually the yellow. It's, I don't know if you could see, but it is a yellow silica powder. I believe it's silica. So powder puff's kind of dirty, but whatever. I love this stuff. I really love the white one also, the translucent one, but this is the one in corrective yellow, and I have it on right now. It doesn't make your skin look yellow, but it is. Next, I'm trying to do this by brand, sort of, kind of, just because, I don't know, it would be easier than jumping around. My next two products. My next two products are from Christian Dior. Both of them were from my last Sephora haul also. The first one would have to be the Christian Dior Lip Balm. This is the Creme de Rose Lip Balm. And as you can see, I have put a nice little dent right in the center. That is the bottom of the container that you see right in the middle. I have been in love with this lip balm. I don't think I've ever said I was in love with a lip balm. Maybe the Kors lip butters. I've been in love with those for a long time, but I am like having an affair with the lip butters. And this would be the Homewrecker. Once this runs out, which it looks like it's going to be running out pretty soon, I will be repurchasing this. I will cringe when I'm at checkout and they ring me up for this one product. It is pricey, I will say that, but it is so worth it to me. I honestly, in my mind, just didn't think it would be worth the money that I spent on it, but it is amazing. It keeps my lips moisturized. I slap it on right when I wake up in the morning, but I slap it on also before I go to bed. I slap it on all throughout the day. Once my lips start even feeling slightly dry, slap it on. Literally, like slap it on my face. Totally love this, totally recommend it. If you have the funds for this, definitely at least try it if you're a lip balm freak like me. Otherwise, don't get it. It does have SPF 10 in it, so that's cool. But yeah, I would only try this if you have, you know, a little bit of splurging money, or if you're just like a balmaholic like me. I love lip balms like crazy. I will try every single lip balm, whether it only costs a dollar, or I would even consider buying like a $100 lip balm if it was considered the most amazing lip balm in the world. I would definitely try it. So if you're one of those type of people, definitely check out the Christian Dior Creme de Rose Lip Balm. It smells like roses in a jar. It is amazing. So that is my first Christian Dior product. The next one is the Amber Diamond Shimmer Powder from Christian Dior. It looks like this. I will slightly swatch it for you. I don't really like sticking my fingers all up in this powder, but I just did, so that is what it looks like. It's a really pretty shimmer. It is right there. You probably can't see it. So okay, if I tilt my hand this way, you can see it right up there. It is an amazing highlight powder. It comes with, let me see. There are five different like little highlight shade highlight shades in there. So yeah, needless to say, it is the best highlighter I have ever purchased, and also, again, a more higher end product. I wouldn't tell everybody, it's not like something that you absolutely need to buy, but I would highly recommend it if you're a highlight freak, and I am a highlight freak as well as I am a balm freak, so I justified that to myself on spending the, what, $40, $50 on this compact. Next two products are not really high-end. They're not really high-end, but they're not like drugstore low-end either. Both of them are from The Balm Cosmetics. And the first one I'm not going to go over too much in this video, only because I'm going to do a whole separate video on swatching it and reviewing it. This is The Balm Cosmetics Nude Eyeshadow Palette. I guess it is their take on Urban Decay's Naked Palette. But these are the amazing colors you get. So you get like your light shimmery colors over here, and then it starts moving on to the brown. There's some brown, shimmery, metallic-y colors, and well, there's really only one shimmery, like, brown right there, and it has like some gold or bronzy flecks going on in there. So yeah, I've been using this every single day since I got it, and I got it maybe like a week and a half, 2 weeks ago. So really in love with this. This is an oldie but a goodie. This is The Balm's Bahama Mama bronzer, and it just looks like this. It is a really nice bronzer. Fit right there. That's like a really super dark swatch, but of course it blends out beautifully. Let me kind of blend it out a little. So that's it blended out right there. Almost done. So I have like three more products. Okay, this one is a little bit on the pricey side. Also something that I really, really love, and I highly, highly recommend, but it's not something that you need to buy or need to have. It's just really, really nice if you kind of want to splurge on yourself a little bit, and if there was like that one makeup item, whether it's for your birthday or your anniversary or your graduation, whatever type of present you can get out of somebody, and you're looking for like a makeup product, this would be it. This is the Rouge Allure Chanel Lip Gloss in the color Caprice. If you don't want this shade, that's absolutely fine. Any Chanel Rouge Allure, by far, is the most amazing lip gloss ever. I have been using this on my lips over top lip balm, over top the Revlon Balm Stains, over top lipstick, alone, everything. It is so amazing. Amazing. The texture is amazing. It doesn't leave that disgusting, stringy monster mouth when you go like that or talk. It is creamy, it is not sticky, it's pigmented, it's long-lasting, long-wearing. When it does wear off, it wears off nicely. This is amazing. Sorry if I'm rambling about this. I didn't mean to dedicate like a whole 3, 4, 5 minutes on this one product, but it deserves it. It is so amazing. This is somewhere in the range of like $30-something. It's almost out. I got it about 2-3 weeks ago. One, I love the color. It's like, it comes with a doe foot applicator. Pink. It's just a beautiful, like, peachy, semi-sheer, semi-opaque. I don't even know if that makes sense. It's just a very pigmented lip gloss. I just, like, want to smack it on my lips right now. Like, I feel like that's such a waste. I could have used that on my lips. But I don't want to put it over top this lipstick, because I don't want this lipstick to transfer to the wand. So this is just amazing. Okay, it is called Caprice, and it is Chanel's Rouge Allure. It just comes in a nice sleek black tube like this, with the gold CC on the top for Chanel. It is an amazing lip gloss. So again, if you have the money, or if someone else has the money and they're offering to buy you something, just get this. Get it. I'm gonna go pick up the other color that came out with this collection, hopefully tomorrow when I get some time. Or maybe I'll wait till Friday when me and my mama cosmetic shopping. So yeah, enough rambling about that. Two more products. L'Oreal's True Match Corrective Concealer. This was just featured in my previous video, which was my drugstore haul, I believe. So I've only maybe had this for a week and a half, 2 weeks, but it's gonna still stay on my favorites because it just, I love this as an under eye concealer. It's so amazing. It just comes with a little brush applicator. It's a liquid concealer. It blends beautifully. It doesn't settle into fine lines. It's just really, really nice under eye concealer. Last product, and that would be L'Oreal's, these are the L'Oreal Lacquer Liner 24 Hour, wait, let me try that one again. These are the 24 Hour L'Oreal Infallible Lacquer Liners. I have two of them. One is in Blackest Black and then Espresso. Blackest Black is just a jet black. This is my newest one that I got recently. And its texture is identical to MAC's Fluid Line in Black Track, which is my favorite gel liner in the whole world. I have like maybe one more use out of my Fluid Line, so I bought this and I'm in love with it. It wears just like the Fluid Line. The texture is just like the Fluid Line. It applies just like the Fluid Line. I love it. So yeah. I'm not going to swatch this on my hand because I don't want to struggle to take it off. But this one is the one in Espresso. It's just a dark, dark brown, and it kind of looks black right there. So let me do side by side. So again, Espresso, Black is Black. I kind of faded them. I tried to fade out the black one. I just put too much. So I faded out like the Espresso one just so you could see more of the brown tone to it. It's a dark, dark brown and a black. I do not have a single gel liner in this deep, dark, rich brown, which is why I originally got it in Espresso before I got it in black. So that's amazing. The darkest brown liner I have is in pencil form, which is the Lancome Kohl liner in Coffee Bean or Coffee something, which is one of my fave waterline liners. So this is way darker than that, and I love that it is. So my search has finally ended for just the almost black brown liner, and this would have to be it. I don't know that they last 24 hours, but I took a nap, and I have the Blackest Black on right now. I took a nap, slept very, very hard, woke up with most of my makeup on my pillow, except it had no black on there, and my liner stayed on. Awesome. So definitely recommend those. And I'm pretty sure that is it for my favorites. I feel like I'm forgetting something. I know I'm forgetting something because it's during when I'm editing the video that I find out I've forgotten something major, and I just cry about it for the remainder of the day. So, but yeah. This video has gone on long enough. I'm going to sign out now, and I just want to thank everybody for watching. If you are still watching, bravo to you. If you are still watching and you are not subscribed to my channel, subscribe. It's on either this side, right above this video. There's a big subscribe button. Click it if it does not have a little green check mark next to it, and I would be the most grateful person ever. Thank you all so much for watching and subscribing if you have. I love you all. I will see you guys in my next video. Bye-bye.